This is a response to Mr. Rogers. I guess I should say the Honorable Congressman Rogers, so we don't get confused. I guess I have to start out by saying that there's a part of me that hears what you're saying. But sometimes I think some of you politicians are missing the personal piece to this. You're missing something. There's something that's not there driving you to make the kind of compromises that you need to make this work. And you talk about these all or nothing choices. Make sure you're examining yourself when you're making those statements, because I'm seeing an awful lot of that as well. This country has become so polarized and so politicized that people want to talk about ideas and they want to talk about concepts and they forget there's real people involved. You have a family right now that lives in Michigan. They have a 17-year-old with leukemia. This family probably will end up living, a family of three, four actually, will probably end up living on $10,000 this year because the husband gets up and goes to work and finds out that there's no work that day, and so they send him home. So he gets maybe 2 days of work out of a week. Okay, tough times for everybody, right? The mother has fibromyalgia, which is a pretty debilitating disease. They're trying to decide whether she's got lupus or not, because there's some other things going on in her system that are just not right. She just got through having a surgery for a massive pituitary tumor. They couldn't get it all. There's some of it still left in there. That's pretty stressful. She has a child with leukemia. Leukemia is not a disease that can be cured. That's pretty stressful. Recently, she's been informed that the chemotherapy that's pretty much destroying his liver and probably a bunch of other organs in his body that he's been going through for the last 3 years has pretty much come to the end of its rope, and, you know, we're not sure where we're going from there. And if he has a relapse, well, the only choice really is a bone marrow transplant, and his body won't take that because of his liver. So they're faced with some pretty difficult days. On top of that, recently, they've been going to yard sales. She's been pulling her shoes out of the closet, selling them off, hoping that they can make the couple hundred dollars that will pay the rent for this month. We'll worry about next month's rent next month. This is a family that is struggling. What are TJ's medical bills? That's the young man's name, TJ. TJ's medical bills are $2.9 million right now. 28 pages. Huge bill. You know what's really cool about that? When he turns 18 and becomes an adult and starts his adult life, not only will he have leukemia, an incurable disease, but he'll have, probably by that time, about $3 million in debt. Isn't that a great way to start your life? Now, this family has already resigned themselves to the fact that they're never going to own a home. They're never going to be able to buy a car. Their credit is wrecked. It's a complete and total disaster for medical bills. There is no way they would qualify to get anything on credit, even if they could. The husband suffers from some real dental problems. And if those don't get taken care of pretty soon, I have a feeling they're going to make him very sick, because dental problems can make you very sick. Don't have money for that. Don't have money to take care of dental problems. We barely have enough money to put food on the table, and right now, they don't even have money for rent. So TJ gets to start his life out. $3 million in debt. He'll never own anything either. So however long he lives, probably going to be pretty miserable. And I guess he's one of those weaker people. Is that what we're about in this country? When you talk about the weaker and the stronger, do you have any idea who those weaker are? And do we just cut them loose? Do we just let them go? As Charles Dickens said, do we just let them die and decrease the surplus population? There's people out there that I'm sure are going to listen to your video and say that. I'm not interested in getting into political rhetoric with you or trading barbs or, you know, being clever with my speaking so that I can make you look bad or make your little talk there seem, you know, less than what it was. Because there are elements of truth in what you're saying, but there are elements of reality in the lives that people live every single day in your very state. This family is in your state. And they're drowning. Drowning. They are underwater long since. Third finger's gone up, fourth finger's gone up. They're going under. I don't know, maybe Michigan's got some programs for homeless people with kids with leukemia. I don't know. Because if something doesn't change pretty soon, that could very well end up where they end up. And so it's this concept of real people with real problems. And you're the elected representative. You're up there to make those tough decisions, to make those tough compromises. Healthcare in our country right now is about profit, not wellness. And no, I don't want to socialize medicine like this is a really, really bad thing, like we don't do that already. Yes, I understand we have social programs that we can't even manage right now. The government does a piss poor job with managing social programs. There's no doubt to that. You talk about turning healthcare over to private entities and, you know, let them creatively figure it out. I'm not convinced that that's going to be a good choice either. Because those private entities are driven by what? By profit. It's not profitable treating a kid with leukemia. There's no profit in that, other than the kid. And in some ways, medicine and treatment and wellness are not profitable up front. It's a long-term profit that you're going to get from that. So I'm not sure that the right idea is to turn everything
over to the private sector. But there has got to be a compromise. There has to be a place
where you guys can come together and figure this out. Are you not intelligent enough to do that? Are you not strong enough to do that? Do you not have the integrity and the backbone to stand up and say, okay, enough of this crap. Enough of the politics, enough of the back and forth, enough of the Nazi stuff and the socialism stuff and all this other crap. Let's roll up our shirt sleeves and do what we get paid to do, which is represent people like this kid that's in your state that you're supposed to be representing. How about stepping up for him? If you can't do it for yourself, and you can't do it for your party, and you can't do it for the country, how about just inviting this kid up to your office and sit down and talk to him? How about asking him about what his life is like? And you'll soon come to find out that, yeah, he's one of those weaker. But can you honestly look him in the eye and say, you know, I can't take from the stronger to help you, the weaker. I'm sorry. There's nothing I can really do.
There has to be something you can do. In this country, the richest country in the world, with some of the smartest people on this planet, we ought to be able to figure this out. And we ought to be able to do it without politics and without all the bullshit rhetoric. You guys need to get in a back room, roll up your sleeves, and do your damn job. That's what you really need to do. I mean, put all this other stuff aside. You really need to pay attention to what's going on in the reality of people's lives and not the rhetoric of the political sphere that you've, you know, kind of enclosed yourself in when you're in Washington. I'm not bashing you. I'm not calling you a big bad Republican or whatever. I don't care about any of that crap. I care about this kid. I care about his family. You should be caring about this kid and his family because they're in your state. You should be figuring out a way that they can get the kind of health care that they need, and it's affordable, and they don't have to go to bed every night trying to figure out where the heck the money's going to come from. That's what you should be doing. And all of the other stuff doesn't matter. Because if you can solve this problem, whatever else you do in your political career will mean nothing when you put it against the magnitude of what you guys are doing up there right now, today, with healthcare. This is one of the most important pieces of legislation you will ever work on. And it's whoever's up there right now, it's your job, your time, this is it. Step up, roll your sleeves up, and get her done. It's time to just get her done. And if somebody loses a little bit of profit, oh well. And if something else has to change, oh well. If there has to be compromises on both sides, oh well. There has to be a way to find a way to make this work. There's lots of countries that have health care. And you can pull out these statistics about, and tell people that, oh my gosh, if we go with, you know, what we're talking about, you're going to get breast cancer and you're going to have less of a chance to live. That is not helpful. It's not changing the situation any. You really need to focus, every single one of you up there, Democrats and Republicans alike, you need to focus on what's really important. You need to call this family up and talk to them about what they're going through. So this is just a video to express some extreme frustration as a U.S. citizen with all of my representatives and senators, because I see you all doing the same thing, talking, jabbing, one-upsmanship, I can do a better analogy than the next guy, and I can pull out some statistics that are going to really cause somebody's hair to stand on end. All the while, you've got this kid who's dying of leukemia. And there's no question. Leukemia is not a curable disease. There is no cure for it right now. So our healthcare system, we have to make a decision. Are we going to take care of these people or are we not? And if we're not, just come right out and say it. We're not taking care of a certain number of people. We're just not going to take care of them. It's just not worth it. But before you make that decision, I'd like for you to bring this young man into your office and look him straight in the eye and tell him he's not worth it. Anyway, think about it. Think about what the heck you're doing up there.